What in the shit is this? What is it?
It's not about that. It's something different. That's all.
I've paid my dues. I've paid my dues. Time after time. I've done my sentence, but committed no crime. And bad mistakes, I've made a few.
Practitioner and number one practitioner for Uncle Bill for many years. Steve's been his friend, he's been his strongest student, and he's been his most public practitioner. Steve was one of the men who fought for the Kunlun Paikun Tau Silat name when it was first presented. He has been the videographer, he has been the writer, he's been the publisher, he's been the publicist, the advertiser, for our Malabar Silat, the Kuntau Silat, the Kunlun Pai Kuntau, the Aratu Duri, the various other Silat aspects that you're familiar with from the Dutoir family. My name is Chaz Clements. I'm a practitioner for 18 years with Uncle Willem and the Dutoir family. I have practitioner certification in a couple of the things that they present, and have been an ardent observer of a number of other kinds of things, a great admirer of them, and somewhat of a scholar in this area.
Mr. Garden is really one of my oldest senior disciples, my best friend.
Y'all are crazy, man.
I'm a guru in Indonesian Silat and a Sifu in Chinese Kuntau. Today, I would like to introduce to you our teacher, William Dutoir's Sigun in the Art of Kuntau and Silat. We'll begin by telling you a little bit about his backyard. He has trained over 50 years in the two arts of Kuntau and Silat. These particular art forms are from the Indonesian archipelago. I will start by telling you some of his background. He has started in Kuntau under instructors of Ling Ping Wang, Tang Tolion, William Chen, and Bak Chen. These are all his Kuntau teachers. His Silat teachers were Haji Samoho, Mas Atmao, and Mas Sojourno. He has studied in these Silat art forms of Chimande, Sikuitang, Pechut Kilat Silat, Banawasa, and Sarak. On the Kuntau side, Kwantung, Hakien, Fukien, Shantung, At this time, I would like to show you our teacher.
Thanks for the introduction, Sifu Morin, and to all and each of you individuals, my regards. I have studied for many years at Kuntao Systems and some Silat, and combined essences and principalities of those styles. Combined together, I call it my salad bowl. And today, that's what you're gonna see, some essences of my salad bowl. I will ask Mr. Morin to do two forms today, Juru Satu, the very first basic fundamental, and to do number two. And then we take it from there and give you an idea what our salad bowl looks like. Thank you. For you, oh, better this way. For the practitioners, the cultural aspects of the art, that's what the application is. Okay, from Juru Satu. Slowly, let's go. Okay, simplify it again. Importance in Evandu Silat. Silat is this. In. Right away in moving. Rocking the boat, I call it. Okay? The very basic practical application and pause. Come, of course, that is a Kuntao basic, but incorporated my salad bowl is workable. Okay. So, the basic foundation in Silat is Silat has to be primitive, simple, non sophisticated, and the reason there is no standards. The real Silat, that is a warrior art. When you do battle, there is no standards to battle. But in the Western world, I repeat, Western world, we have to standardize everything. A warrior would approach it this way. You see, there's a blade. Silat is the blading art. In Western version, we have to do it this way to standardize it to that. I'm thankful I got you seniors to come up with basics, because I cannot teach basics. The way I was taught, Silat is plain simple. This is a basic move.
my dues. I've paid my dues. Time after time, I've done my sentence, but committed no crime.